Hello everyone. Welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Saroj Yadav, Assistant Professor in Department of Education, University of Allahabad. Today we will discuss about the centrally sponsored schemes for the elementary education, its assumptions, implementation, strategies and impact. The objectives of this module are to give the students an understanding of assumptions and implementation of centrally sponsored schemes for the universalization of elementary education, to help the students understand the strategies and impact of centrally sponsored schemes for the universalization of elementary education. Many centrally sponsored schemes in India have been implemented for the universalization of elementary education. In this module, we will discuss about the assumptions, implementations, strategies and impact of these schemes such as Education for All, Operation Blackboard, District Primary Education Program, Midday Meal, Education Guarantee Scheme, Sarva Siksha Abhiyan, Kasturba Gandhi Balika Vidyalay, PMOST and SOPT, Minimum Level of Learning, Mahila Samakhya, etc. So first, let's see about Education for All. In 1990, a world conference was organized in Thailand on the topic Education for All, in which emphasis was given on the basis of learning needs of every people, so that all may be capable to take the benefits of education. Then in India, Education for All project was started for the universalization of primary education in 1992. Main objectives of this project was universalization of enrollment in primary education, completion of the period of education, provision to take benefits of educational opportunities, etc. Apart from this, use of education as a mean of equality, enhancement in the quality of education, decentralization of educational planning and management were also the objectives of Education for All project. Different programs in different states were also started for the fulfillment of these objectives, such as Lok Jumbish in Rajasthan, UP Basic Education Project, Bihar Education Project in Bihar, etc. Now we will see about Operation Blackboard. After independence, many primary schools were established and their number is increasing continuously. But there was adverse effect on the quality of education due to the increased number of schools. Essential requirements were not considered during the opening of primary schools. Many schools lacked toilets, drinking water, blackboard, study materials, playground, etc. According to All India survey, it was found that there was no school building of 9% schools. 41.5 schools were lacking blackboard. 72% schools had not library. 53.45% schools were lacking playground. 89.5% schools of rural areas were not having toilets. Drinking water was also not available in many schools. So it was realized to need the reformation of primary education in National Education Policy 1986. Program of action was prepared by MHRD for the planning of educational activities and development. National Policy of Education 1986 has recommended for many innovative experiments and programs for primary education. Operation Blackboard is one of them. Operation terms indicate that projects should be run very fast. It is national project, objectives of which is to provide desired facilities and infrastructure for primary schools. Operation Blackboard was started in 1987-88 for providing essential requirement in primary schools. Operation Blackboard scheme was also implemented for upper primary schools from 1993 to 94. Necessary resources and infrastructure facilities for primary schools are 3 classrooms, minimum 2 teachers in which 1 female teacher, essential sports materials, blackboard, maps, charts and other teaching learning materials. For upper primary school, 1 more teacher is required, where students' number is more than 100. Responsibility of providing school building was on the National Rural Development Program. From 2002 to 2003, Operation Blackboard was merged with Sarv Siksha Abhiyan. As we have come to know that essential infrastructure and resources have been provided to primary and upper primary schools under this scheme. But training of teachers for using these equipments are also necessary. Evaluation of Operation Blackboard scheme indicates that teachers lack training for the use of these teaching learning materials. Uniforms given to students are not according to the local needs. There is no any provision for the maintenance of these equipments under this scheme. Much emphasis is given in rural areas, SCST areas and girls' school under this scheme. Now let's see about district primary education program. District primary education program was started by central government in 1994. Central government bears 85% and concerned district government bears 15% of total financial burden of this project. Our government is getting financial support by outsources like UNICEF, Netherlands, International Development Authority, etc. Major objectives of this project is to provide quality primary education. Its other objectives are to decrease the dropout rates up to 10%, 5% decrease in the discrimination in the field by enrollment, learning achievement, etc. on the basis of caste and gender. Enhancement of learning level of students is also one of the major objectives of this project. Unit for the implementation of district primary education program is district. DPEP has started more than 2 lakh schools and around 90,000 alternative school centers. Around 4 crore students are getting education in these alternative education centers. More than 2 crore students are getting benefits of different types of bridge courses. Due to the efforts of DPEP, enrollment rate of students has been significantly enhanced. Dropout rate in standard 1 to 5 has been significantly decreased to 10%. Significant growth has been seen for girls' enrollment. 3,380 resource centers has been established at the block level. Purpose of these resource centers is to provide teaching aids and teaching training. Major functions of district primary education program are the establishment of new schools, new classrooms, alternative education centers, block resource centers, etc. Apart from this, it also works for the recruitment of teachers, empowerment of SCERT and diets, etc. Arrangement of teachers' training, development of teaching learning materials, etc. In many emphasizes to accept the innovations for the education of girls, SCST and differently abled persons. In district primary education program, investment per district is limited to rupees 40 crore for a project period of 5 to 7 years. 33.5% of the total amount is to be spent on civil work and 6% on the management cost. remaining amount is to be spent on the quality improvement activities. At present, this program is getting external assistance of approximate ₹6,938 crore. International Development Authority is providing approx ₹5,137 crore and grants of ₹1,801 crore is coming from EC, DFID, UNICEF, Netherlands, etc. Approx 1,60,000 new schools and 84,000 alternative schools have been opened under this program. Progress of this program shows the 52,758 school buildings, 58,604 additional classrooms, 16,619 resource centers, 29,307 repairing work, 64,600 toilets and 25,000 drinking water facilities. Approx 3.5 million children are getting the advantages of alternative schools and another 2 lakh students are covered with bridge courses. There was significant increase in enrollment of students also. For phase first states, the gross enrollment ratio was around 95% for the last 3 years. After adjusting the enrollment of alternative schools and education guarantee schemes, GER is 100%. There is significant improvement in girls' enrollment also. In first phase district of DPEP, girls' enrollment was 49% of the total enrollment. Approx 4,20,200 differently able students were enrolled, which was almost 76% of approx 5,53,800 differently able children in district primary education program states. Approx 1,77,000 teachers including para teachers and Shiksha Karmi were appointed. Village Education Committee and School Management Committee has been set up in almost all the district covered in DPEP. Now, we will see about Midday Meal Project. This project was started from 15th August 1995. It is also called as National Program of Nutritional Support to Primary Education. Its main purpose is to provide nutritional food with encouraging their regular attendance and enrollment. More than 10 crore primary students are getting benefits of this project. Now, milk is also provided with cooked food. Now, let's see about Education Guarantee Scheme and Innovative Education. It is the important link in the process of universalization of primary education. Major objective of this scheme is to provide primary education for the dropouts of age group 6 to 14 years of slum areas. Important work of this project is to establish education guarantee scheme schools in the areas where there was lacking. It is also provided bridge courses for the dropouts. This project links by flexible process to those children who have not got the school facilities due to domestic work. This is a national project governed by central government. Ratio of financial burden is 75:25 for central and state government. In education guarantee scheme, whole responsibility is not on the government, but also on the community. It gives emphasis on the cooperation of government and community. It also laid emphasis on quality-based minimum education facilities. It ensures that time-bound plan and minimum essential norms should be fulfilled. It is the effort of education guarantee scheme that statutory framework should be defined education as an enforceable right. It is also enforces the government to provide the educational packages in the areas where primary schools are not within the areas of 1 kilometer. Major components of education guarantee scheme are teachers, teaching learning materials, training of teachers, evaluation and supervision, etc. Now we will see about Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan. Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan was started on the basis of 86th amendment of the Indian Constitution 2002. This project was started for providing primary education to approximately 19.2 crore students of 11 lakh families from 600 districts. Its major objectives are completion of 5 years of primary education of age group 6 to 14, completion of 8 years of upper primary education, arrangement of quality primary education, etc. Major functions of Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan are to establish new schools where these are lacking, to strengthen the fundamental structure of schools, to arrange the training of teachers, to arrange the teaching learning materials, etc. Apart from these efforts, this project encourages community participation, arrangement of community education, etc. It provides emphasis on the arrangement of girls' education and education of deprived section. SSA provides much emphasis on SC, ST and other deprived persons. Efforts of providing computer education in rural areas is also implementing in Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan. Now, let's see about Kasturba Gandhi Balika Vidyalay. As all of us know that gender disparities exist with respect to enrollment and retention of students in primary schools. Within last 25 years, enrollment of girls has grown from 5 million to 47 million in primary schools and 0.5 million to 16 million in upper primary schools. But even though girls' enrollment is very only 46% in primary schools and 38% in upper primary schools, dropout rates of girls are higher than those of boys. Many programs for encouraging girls' education are implementing by government and non-government organizations. Kasturba Gandhi Balika Vidyalay scheme is one of them. This scheme was launched by Government of India in 2004. Its main purpose was to set up residential schools for upper primary girls students of SCST, OBC and minority group of remote areas. It is a separate scheme, but harmonized Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan and Mahila Samakhya for the first 2 years. It was merged with Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan. Kasturba Gandhi Balika Vidyalay scheme is implementing in the educationally backward areas where there is concentration of tribal population with the female literacy is below national average or a large number of girls students are out of school. This scheme is also applicable for the areas where there is concentration of SC, OBC and minorities with low female literacy rate and areas with a large number of small scattered habitations. Now, let's know about the program of mass orientation of school teachers and special orientation program for primary teachers. Dear students, as we know that teachers' skills and performance are the most important criteria for enhancing the quality of education. For improving the quality and competency of teachers, their in-service and pre-service training is necessary. For this purpose, centrally sponsored scheme of restructuring and reorganization of Teacher Education was launched in 1987. Program of Mass Orientation of School Teachers and Special Orientation Program for Primary Teachers are the major programs of this scheme. Almost 1.8 million primary and upper primary schools teachers were trained under this scheme. Major objectives of this program was to orient school teachers for the priorities and directions of National Policy of Education 1986. It was also aimed to improve the professional competencies of primary and upper primary school teachers. Another main program of RRTE was the organization of Special Orientation Program for Primary Teachers. It was launched in 1993-94 and now implementing in almost all the states. Its purpose was to provide training to teachers for using the materials and teaching aids of Operation Blackboard. Its another objective is to orient the teachers for minimum level of learning strategy for the teaching of language, mathematics and environment studies. More than 1,15,000 school teachers have been trained. Now, we will learn about minimum level of learning. As we have come to know that continuous efforts are doing to enhance the enrollment and retention of students in primary schools for the purpose of universalization of primary education. Many primary schools and non-formal education centers have been opened. More and more students are getting facilities of primary education. But it is also true that there is much difference in the infrastructure of these institutions, teaching learning processes, quality of students, etc. Education standard of the primary schools of remote and rural areas are very poor. So, it has been felt that there is need to eradicate the dissimilarities of the education provided by the primary schools. For this purpose, minimum level of learning of students is also necessary, along with the enhancement of the infrastructure of primary schools, training of teachers and reformation of teaching aids, etc. The need of minimum level of learning arises from the assumption that irrespective of caste, creed, location or gender, all students must be given access to education of a comparable standard. It should be ensured by evaluation process that all students are getting minimum level of learning. Thus, strategy of minimum level of learning is an attempt to get quality with equity. It assumes learning outcomes in the form of competencies or levels of learning at each stage of primary education, as well as for non-formal education centers also. It has been recommended in National Policy of Education 1986 that minimum level of learning should be determined very soon and proper arrangements should be done to get it. Then in January 1990, MHRD has organized a committee of 11 members presiding by Dr. R. H. Dave. This committee did very important work for the determination of MLL on elementary level. By this committee, MLL for language, mathematics and environmental studies has been produced both for formal and non-formal elementary education. It has been stressed that emphasis should be given on concept formation rather than content. Overloading of the content leads to rote memorization. In new MLL approach, emphasis is given on concept rather than content, understanding rather than rote memorization, achievable set of competencies rather than unachievable content load. Minimum level of learning has been specified in terms of competencies expected to be mastered by every student by the end of the particular standard. Minimum level of learning can be defined in terms of desirable learning outcomes, learning competencies on educational objectives. The way committee has been determined minimum level of learning in terms of minimum learning abilities, both cognitive as well as non-cognitive domains have been combined in minimum level of learning. MLL are helpful for providing direction to teaching learning process and determination of responsibilities of teachers. Determination of MLL is also helpful for the reformation of curriculum, comprehensiveness, achievement, communication along with evaluation. The program has been initiated throughout the country with the help of NGOs, voluntary agencies, research institutions, etc. MLL for the upper primary stage are now being finished. Major strategies of minimum level of learning are to develop the competencies-based teaching and learning. It is expected by the minimum level of learning that there may be quality enhancement in elementary education. Now, let's see about the scheme to provide quality education in madrasas, that is SPQEM. In order to improve the quality of education in madrasas, the scheme was introduced to enable Muslim children attain standards of the national education system in formal education subjects. The salient features of this scheme as per the MHRD's central schemes for elementary education are to strengthen capacities in madrasas for teaching of the formal curriculum subjects like science, mathematics, language, social sciences, etc. through enhanced payment of teacher honorarium. Next is training of such teachers every 2 years in the new pedagogical practices. Next is providing science labs, computer labs with annual maintenance cost in the secondary and higher secondary stage madrasas. Next is provision of science and mathematics kits in primary and upper primary level madrasas. Strengthening of libraries and providing teaching learning materials at all levels of madrasas. Next is the unique features of this modified scheme is that it encourages linkage of madrasas with National Institute of Open Schooling, that is NIOS, as accredited centers for providing formal education, which will enable children studying in such madrasas to get certification for class 5th, 8th, 10th and 12th. This will enable them to transit to higher studies and also ensure the quality standards to the national education system. Registration and examination fees to the NIOS will be covered under this scheme. Next is the NIOS linkage will be extended under this scheme for vocational education at the secondary and higher secondary stage of madrasas. For the monitoring and popularization of the scheme, it will fund state madrasa boards. Government of India will itself run periodic evaluation, the first within 2 years. Now, another scheme for infrastructure development in minority institutes, that is IDMI. IDMI aims to develop infrastructure in private aided and unaided minority schools and institutions in order to enhance quality of education for minority children. The salient features of IDMI scheme are as follows. First is the scheme would facilitate education of minorities by strengthening school infrastructure in minority institutions in order to expand facilities for formal education to children of minority communities. Next is the scheme will cover the entire country, but preference will be given in minority institutions located in districts, blocks and towns having a minority population above 20%. Next is, the scheme will encourage educational facilities for girls, children with special needs and those who are most deprived educationally among minorities. Next is, the scheme will fund infrastructure development of private aided and unaided minority institutions to the extent of 75% and subject to a maximum of rupees 50 lakhs per institution for strengthening of educational infrastructure and physical facilities in the existing school, including additional classrooms, science and computer lab rooms, library rooms, toilets, drinking water facilities and hostel buildings for children, especially for girls. Now, we will see about the scheme for women education, that is Mahila Samakhya. It was assumed by National Policy of Education 1986 that education can be effective tool for the empowerment of women. Mahila Samakhya program was launched in 1986 to fulfill the objectives of empowerment of women through education. Major objectives of Mahila Samakhya is education for women's equality. Parameters of women empowerment are mainly enhancing self-esteem and self-confidence of women, develop ability to think critically, ensuring equal participation in developmental processes, etc. Its objectives is also to build a positive image of women by recognizing their contribution to the society and economy. Mahila Samakhya program also ensures to provide information, knowledge and skills for economic independence and enabling women to make choices in areas like education, employment, etc. It was launched in Karnataka, Gujarat and UP with Dutch assistance. In 1992, this project was extended to Andhra Pradesh also. Mahila Samakhya is now being implemented in 2,252 villages of UP, Bihar, MP and Assam. In UP, 6 districts, in Bihar, 7 districts, in MP, 3 districts and in Assam, 3 districts are covered by Mahila Samakhya. In MP and Assam, Mahila Samakhya project is funded by DPEP also. Significant gender disparities exist in rural areas and among disadvantaged communities with respect to education. It was initiated to fulfill the goals of NPE and Program of Action for the Education and Empowerment of Women in Rural Areas from socially and economically marginalized groups. Mahila Samakhya has adopted many innovative approaches to fulfill its target. Mahila Samakhya emphasizes not only to acquire basic literacy skills, but also give emphasis on the process of learning to question, problem solving, critical analysis of different issues, etc. Mahila Samakhya has proved itself as an effective way to mobilize and organize women. So now, dear students, let's have a brief review of this module. This module has demonstrated about centrally sponsored schemes for the universalization of elementary education, such as Education for All, Operation Blackboard, District Primary Education Program, Midday Meal Project, Education Guarantee Scheme, Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, Kasturba Gandhi Balika Vidyalay, Minimum Level of Learning, Scheme for Infrastructure Development in Minority Institutes, Mahila Samakhya, etc. We have learned about the assumptions, implementations, strategies and impact of these schemes. Education for All project was started for the universalization of primary education in 1992. Main objectives of this project was universalization of enrollment in primary education, completion of the period of education, provision to take benefits of educational opportunities, etc. Operation Blackboard was started in 1987-88 for providing essential requirement in primary schools. This scheme was also implemented for upper primary schools from 1993-94. Sarva Siksha Abhiyan was started on the basis of 86th amendment of the Indian Constitution 2002. Mahila Samakhya program was launched in 1986 to fulfill the objectives of empowerment of women through education. Thank you.